It's great to greet you all through this video and to bring you an update of some of the things happening around our territory. Here are some of the recent highlights.
We have an exciting opportunity next year to work with 500 young people nationally through our Aspire Kiwi Youth Development Program. Based on our successful community youth ministries model, each Aspire program is a year-long journey for 10 vulnerable young people, with weekly group meetings, an outdoor adventure experience, and a community project to promote good citizenship. The way to be accepted into Aspire, families need to sign up alongside their young person. So this provides a fantastic opportunity for CORE to link with their families in their community. The Warehouse Group is providing funding for 30 programs nationwide, so we are looking for CORE to step up and offer Aspire to their communities. We will provide funding and training. You just need an enthusiastic facilitator. If you're interested in running an Aspire program, please contact your Divisional Youth Secretary.
For the first time as a Territory, we have donated more than $1 million to the International Self-Denial Appeal. Thank you for your generous support. You may not realise that as well as the Self-Denial Appeal, our Territory is involved directly in a number of other overseas development projects. For example, I have just returned from the Philippines, where I was able to observe our feeding and medical sponsorship program and to visit the children to whom we have provided education scholarships. This was just so exciting. Another example is our Hope Gifts. For as little as $5, you can give someone a toothbrush and toothpaste or a school stationery kit. Or for a bit more, you could transform a family by offering them a goat or a sewing machine. This Christmas, will you include Hope Gifts in your giving?
In other happenings around the Territory, in October, over 200 people across four locations went homeless for 14 hours to raise awareness of the increasing issue of homelessness in New Zealand.
The Tongan region has been working hard on TSMP goal number 2 and is celebrating 150 soldiers in Tonga, up 20%.
In our recent visit to Fiji, we were blown away by the enthusiasm and participation of the young people and children at the Saweni Corps.
Kolawai Corps plant in Tonga is really enjoying their new Corps building, built with help from Whangarei Corps to replace their leaking tent.
Our corporate sponsorships continue to be very generous.
We've recently had Colonels Willis and Barbara Howell join us as our Chief Secretary and Territorial Secretary of Women's Ministries. We've invited them to share briefly their first impressions of our incredible territory.
Hello friends, kia ora, bula and mahalo. It's so nice to greet all of you and to thank you for the very warm reception we've received thus far in this territory.
We have been so excited about going to 3 youth councils where we have seen young adults and teenagers enjoying going deeper with God.
And we've also found a very passionate Salvation Army in this territory. People who are focused on the mission, the TSMP seems to give us great direction and great focus. And all in all, we've been so impressed by all that we've seen. Thank you very much and God bless you.
Christmas this year takes on special significance as it is exactly 200 years since the gospel was first preached in New Zealand. The Salvation Army is proud to mark this occasion by supporting the Hope Project, and we trust that you are making the most of the resources and advertising that is available. I'd like to highlight something that is concerning Janine and I as we travel around the territory. Our Soldiers and Officers Covenants commit us to a joint ministry of sharing the good news of Jesus Christ and caring for the needy and disadvantaged. Yet we are observing that in many lives in Salvation Army settings, we seem to select one part or the other, or we do them both but don't join them. Our Territorial Strategic Mission Plan calls us to work as a mission-focused army, a whole-of-mission-focused army that is connected. This will be a particular focus of ours moving forward. For example, it's a busy time of the year. Like here at the Hope Centre in Wellington, your Corps or Centre will be involved with extra Christmas outreach, and we expect to hand out gifts and hampers to more than 14,000 families in need. Let us each help serve people in need and use the 200-year celebration to strike up conversations about the good news of Jesus Christ.
God gave his greatest gift to us on that first Christmas day. May the wonder of that gift be with you and your families this Christmas season.